I freaking love sports. I love watching them. Sometimes I even love playing them, but really, they kill me. I remember one day when I'm 10 years old, I go in for a basketball tryout. Everyone gets in, of course, and my dad was coaching, although he knew how crap I was, so he couldn't be biased even if he tried. I go in and I immediately fall over. A great way to start off my basketball tryout. So I come up with a brilliant plan. Jog in circles until my teammates get the picture. I do this all year until one day during a game, the ball lands at my feet. One kid takes a glance at me and I panic, so I throw the ball with all my might directly into the backboard, and it launches right back into my face. I get up just in time to see this huge kid barreling towards me, headed straight for the ball that has coincidentally fallen right into my hands. I turn for a split second and stare into my father's desperate blue eyes as he screams, "Danny, move! Come on, you've got the ball! Hustle!" And so I pick up the ball, and with my signature will, I barrel down the court right past this kid and once again launch it at the backboard. This time, it knocks this kid's head in. Only this time he gets knocked out and we have to postpone the game. If anything can prove to you more than that, that exercise is a terrible thing, please let me know, because at this point in my life, I feel like that's more than enough evidence to put me right back in my chair at home. Thank you.
Trying to check in. Are we still going to the library later?
Yeah, we are. Book's already there. I'm just waiting for you now.
Alright, well, I just finished doing my routine at the recreation center. The parents seem to eat it up as per usual. The little ones, not so much.
Yes. The cute little boys. My sweet, beautiful little boys.
Yes. If only they allowed little girls at Saturday morning comedy, too.
You see, they simply can't handle your brutal, masculine charm. You're simply too manly, too aggressive.
Fire and vigor in my eyes. I'll see you in 3.
You won't be there for another 4.
Are you sure about that?
Enlighten me, you dumb prick.
All right, well, according to...
Hi, I've written a full outline of the project and the binding pattern in 3 sections, hopefully pertaining to each of our skill sets.
I'm already bored.
Honestly saying, I just came from comedy hour, already hard enough getting parents to laugh, let alone children. I swear to God, if you punch me again, I will flip out in this library.
Okay, little boy.
Well, at least neither of you two have had to do any of the work or research so far. I've been here for 2 hours.
Yes, and I've been at home.
Doing what? Playing piano or still pretending you hate rap on the internet?
Ooh, what a rose!
Looks like somebody grew some pubes.
Okay, so correct me if I'm wrong, but this isn't Morse code, so... What the frick?
Do you think I should say it?
Yeah, go for it.
Should I? Really?
Yes!
No, but seriously this time.
If you say really one more time, I swear-
Drum roll, please. Last night, I hooked up with someone.
Bam!
Who?
Oh yeah, wait, who?
Really, all that winking and you never gave a name? Disappointing.
It was Alex.
Alex? Alex, as in Alex from middle school.
Mm-hmm.
Alex isn't that crappy guy from this past year who said he was in love with you.
Yep.
Alex isn't that creepy guy who decided to hang out under your window at 7 a.m. on a Sunday morning because he thought it would show off his devotion to you or something. That, Alex?
Well, now you say it that way, I'm so regretted, but here's the thing! Where are you going?
Away from here, if you excuse me for a moment. Oh, my goodness, sorry.
Oh, hey, no worries at all. Wait a second, dude! I totally recognize you.
You do?
Yeah, you're the janitor from the recreation center. My little brother and my mom watch you there every Saturday.
Oh, hey, listen, that's really awesome, but I really gotta go.
Hey, aren't you like Rose's best friend or something?
Yeah, I guess I am.
Oh, cool. Hi, I'm Alex.
Oh. Hi, hello, nice to meet you, friend, pal, buddy, associate.
How are you doing? Doing just fine, thank you very much. Actually, can I talk to you for a sec?
Yeah, sure, man. What about exactly?
It's about Rose.
Cool beans, my dude, cool beans. So, what do you need?
All I can say is, I love her. So what? The hell do I do?
You what? Okay, just come with me this way. A nice chat, just the two of us. Okay, so you tell me you went to her to apologize for all the creepiness and whatnot.
Yeah, that's right.
And then you hugged her as any normal person after settling a disagreement would.
Yeah.
And then she made a move on you.
Yeah, it was crazy, man. She just started going at it, and I didn't know what to do. I just thought I'd gotten over, and she was so kind, and then she just started telling my face, man. Like, how do you react to something like that, man? You know?
Here's the thing, Alex. You gotta tell her this to her face. Now.
That's why I came to you, man.
So, why are you still standing here?
Getting ready, I guess.
Getting ready? I mean, what do you mean? Like, she's right down the hall. Go ask her.
I kind of can't.
But here you are, dressed in all clearly expensive and high-quality clothing. Looking both tough and fine as hell. Even more so than you used to, and yet now you're telling me you want to sit here quietly and wait for this thing to work itself out on its own.
Yeah, that sounds about right to me.
Yeah. Anyways, pal, you gotta make a plan, because she's high-pilling about it here soon, and you gotta get her to sit down with you and let you talk your ears off before she develops an escape plan.
All right. I can do that. But can you help me?
No, dumbass! You're gonna be an adult within a year, if you're not even an adult already. And at some point or another, you people are gonna have to learn how to deal with these things on your own. Because I'm not gonna let you drag me into it. And she's in the room down the hall on your next right. Rosa! What perfect timing. Here, come on in. Alex, you may leave the charge to wherever you desire.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it. Hello, Rosa. Would you like to maybe go out to a study room or the park bench outside?
Fine.
So long, you young romantics. You come back anytime.
You're really a piece of work, you know that?
Not the worst.
On you.
Yep, had fun giving him those little clips of wisdom.
Well, it worked out in the end. Turns out he's really dedicated to not being a creep this time.
Sentence I never thought I'd have to hear.
It's really not the worst thing you've heard.
Not from your mouth, it's not. Oh,
I didn't think you'd bracket it.
She has problems, just makes it feel even worse.
You're telling me? 2 days ago at the library, even the sight of Alex repels her. Now she can't get enough of him.
Yeah, I've seen worse.
I'm sure you have. Hey!
Hey, Willa, how's it hanging? Ethan!
What's up? Hey, guys! What's up?
Nothing much. We're just about to head down to the center. You in?
Sure.
Oh, E, could you hang tight for a sec? I want to talk to you.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sure.
Good luck.
So, what's up, my dude?
I just wanted to say thank you for the other day, man. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, no worries.
Oh, just so you know, I'm really good at working out and stuff. I could really help you in that area if you'd like. Free membership at the school gym and everything. Everyone knows me there because I go all the time, so it'd be pretty easy.
Oh, well, I'm looking forward to it.
I just wanted to know if you like everyone.
Are you being serious, or is this a
no,
joke?
I'm asking!
Legitimately.
Do you like anyone? Girl? Guy? Doesn't matter. I don't judge.
Good to know. No, I do not like anyone right now. I haven't in a while. Why?
Making sure.
Making sure of what?
Just making sure you didn't like my girl, is all.
Your girl?
Yeah, my girl, Rosa. I mean, you don't like her.
No, and right now I doubt I could, even if I tried.
Awesome. Just so you know, I wasn't kidding about that gym membership thing. Eh? Got a whole lot of muscular guys, kind of like myself, all revved up and sweaty. Right behind me, all the time, just in case things get
dangerous.
You know what I mean? I'm gonna kick up with those guys now.
Hey, you should come with.
It's gonna be a lot of fun, especially with you and me there, right?
Yeah, huh? I'm sorry, I have things to do at home, Alex.
Alright, have fun. Bye.
And so I turn the corner and she's just standing right there, and I'm just like, oh, I can't crowd, I'm in trouble now! And so before she gets the chance to look up, I shove it between my cheeks in the hopes that maybe she mistakes it for a couple days without wiping. Oh god, it was terrible, just awful!
Yeah, it sure sounds like it sucks. What did you think, Rosa? I mean, was that funny or what? Right?
Yeah.
It's
Totally. Thanks, Willa. That was a great story.
Sure, anytime. Got a whole lot more stories if anybody's interested.
I think it's about time we all start heading home. We've got homework to do. Rosa, specifically, you and I gotta get cleared up on that project by Wednesday.
Yeah, totally. Hey, my mom just texted me that she's pulling over, so I gotta go.
Alright, bye. Love you.
Yeah. What was all that about?
Was all that about?
You know, like, asking her all those questions and stuff.
I just wanted to make sure she was really having as much fun as she said she was.
Okay, and you couldn't tell just by looking at her face.
Girls lie, dude, people. Like, you can tell what's going on in their heads. It's all crazy bullshit. She's lied to me before.
Well, I'm going to go home. Staying safe.
Okay. Ethan, wait!
Yeah? What is
it? You trust me, right? You believe me? You believe in me?
Yeah. I've always got your back. You know this. You know this.
Thanks.
Night.
All right, all right. Funny stuff, funny stuff. What do we have tonight, funny man? Okay. Wisdom teeth story, outlier project. Maybe that one time in freshman year I got cast in that student-run show, Davidson Corky and the Enigmatically Dirtied Sponge. Or maybe muscular guys in expensive outfits who try to threaten me. Hey, Alex, what's up?
E, my buddy, my pal, just calling out some advice.
Ah, well, I'll see what I can do to help.
How can you tell if a girl likes you or is having a good time with you, even though she's not saying it?
Well, that's a toughie. Well, have you tried looking at her? That might help your cause.
That's what Ethan said, but I'm not buying it. Surely there's gotta be more to it than that.
As in?
Words? Feelings? Sensations of touch? I don't know. You gotta help me out here, man. Rosa doesn't talk at all, but she talks all the time around you. What's so special about you? What's going on here, man? What's the big picture?
Here's a picture, Alex. Some people who are nervous talk more. Some talk less. Rosa does a little bit of both. She needs balance. Sometimes she's going to be silent, sometimes not, meaning you won't be able to read her at every second of the day.
Well, that's upsetting.
I'm sure it is, but you're going to have to learn to live with that sort of thing. If you want this relationship to be something more.
All right. I can do that. Thanks, E. For everything.
Anything for my pal, Alex.
See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow sounds fabulous. Bye, Alex. So. Davidson Corkeet it is.
Later.
Yeah, but I don't wanna.
Hey, project's grade up, 95!
Hey, we gotta celebrate!
Brooke, it's Thursday night, we have school tomorrow.
What, like taking a break from homework for 10 minutes is gonna kill us? Please, Rosa, some soda and chocolate isn't the end of the world.
Oh no, I just thought, you know. What about, never mind, just get some soda.
Alright, alright. So, do you want a specific flavor, diet, or what? Because I know you like root beer. But there's only one left, and if you don't want it, I'm taking it. Hello? Ah! I'm guessing the celebration is canceled then?
What? Oh, Brooke. Yeah, I think I'm gonna spend some time with Alex tonight.
Yeah, no worries. I'll clean up my things. Hey, Alex.
Oh, hey, Brooke.
So, wanna hook up on the couch?
Hell yeah. Honestly, we can do it right here if you want.
Okay.
Wait.
What?
Do you mind if I film this?
Yeah. Do you want to film this gross and weird?
Problem, honey.
Go!
It's just a little bit of filming.
We're teenagers.
Rosa?
Get out!
Fine! I'm going. Have fun spending the rest of your night without me.
Not in the mood, Elias.
Oh boy, guess we're on first name basis now, huh? What's wrong, Rosa?
I'm fine.
Sure about that?
Yes. No.
Alright, what happened? Brooke seemed pretty shaken up for a few minutes that I saw her today.
That's great, just perfect, beautiful.
Rosa, what happened?
Last night, Alex and I, we had an argument. He wanted to film us hooking up, and, you know.
Film? Film it?
Yeah, film it. It was gross, and it made me uncomfortable. I couldn't handle it, so I kicked him out. I mean, what is so hard to understand about saying no? I didn't want to film us hooking up, so he left, and I was alone. I had no one to talk to. I disappointed two people that night. It was just awful.
Well, this is a hard topic. It's good that you're getting it off your chest. Why not? How about we play a song?
What song?
I don't know. An easy one? A calming one, maybe.
How about the classic?
Are you talking?
Perfect. I'll take top.
Bottom it is. Thank you.
Alright, so since I skipped over the musical last week, I can do it this week, right? Why, Eli, that would be amazing. Yes, thank you, kind sir. I appreciate your exuberantly delivered commentary. I only wish I could do more for you and your beautiful, beautiful children. You la do, sadi fondu, and the one, the only, yee! Oh my god, Alex! How are you here and why?
I followed you in.
You what?
I came in early. I followed you in.
All right. Well, we should probably start talking before I have to get
oh,
started.
Oh, yeah, 100%. So, basically, I was walking down Hawthorne with my pals, you know, like, Ethan and stuff, and, you know
Alex,
that really...
Alex, get to the point.
Do you think it'd be weird if I hooked up with a guy, and no, not gay, not homosexual, or anything that doesn't interfere with the relationship, just friends being friends, right?
So you're telling me you just had casual sex with another dude?
No, we made out. That's all.
And this was just some guy you didn't know well, or...
Oh, no, it was Ethan.
Ethan is gay!
Okay, but...
Hey, Alex, you can't just do things like that.
Well, that's just plain old homophobic.
God sakes, Alex, who cares if you're gay or not? Because in this current situation, it's completely irrelevant the fact that you just cheated on Rosa. Sorry, that's not what you needed to hear.
What do I need to hear then?
Not that. Listen, it's okay to be gay. And it's okay if you're not. Things happen.
Thanks. We appreciate that. I think I'd better go. I've got things to do. See you around.
Hey, look who it is.
I'm sorry about last week.
Are you?
I am.
I bend over backwards for you, Rosa, and you treat me like crap. I don't know what's going on with you, and it's creeping me out.
I'm fine.
No, you're not.
Look, I only contacted you to apologize. Now if you're going to attack like this, I'm not going to deal with it.
Rosa, you're the one who attacked me like this in the first place.
Oh, bigger than you are, huh?
Rosa, don't.
Don't what? Don't criticize you? Don't tick you off because you're so goddamn sensitive? If you have as many problems as me.
Rosa, stop it.
Stop? Now you're offended because I have something to say, but you're completely comfortable when you're the one who completely overtakes me. Ah!
Want me to check on Rosa because...
Jesus Christ, Eli, do you have to ask so many questions?
Yes, and I'm in the park enjoying the sunnyside view. Sounds like there's a particular issue you should be dealing with. Like a mature adult, instead of contacting me...
Well, I'm sorry that I can't rely on myself right now because I'm not exactly in the most perfect of emotional states.
But what the hell did you do?
Eli, I think I may have given her an anxiety attack. And you know what that means.
Rosa, come on! Damn it, Rosa!
Eve, how are you doing here? You could have went on my dog to my parents.
Rosa, it's noon. Whatever, I'm not going to judge. I heard you had an incident and wanted to make sure you were okay.
Well, thanks, but I'm fine.
Rosa, this isn't right.
Eli, I need you to leave.
I just want to help you, Rosa.
Go!
This isn't right.
Get out!
Alex cheated on you, you know? He hooked up with Ethan during a group hangout with friends. Says he likes it.
He hooked up with Ethan. Well, that's just great, huh? I guess he's gay or bi or who cares, right?
Disappointed in you, Rosa.
Get out, Eli! I need to leave!
Bye.
Bye!
American sandwich. Blonde apple Schmidt. Oh, Alex. That's gross.
How is it going? I'm doing pretty great so far.
Hey, you need to talk to Rose about some stuff.
You?
Not too much in all honesty. I'm busy and exhausted.
Does it involve Rosa and I being together?
No, just regular old school, Alex. Takes a real toll.
That's good. Good if it did. I totally would have kicked your ass!
Alex, are you high?
I'm vodka too.
How often do you do this?
Oh, all the time. School creates a really competitive environment. It's sort of good.
Trust me, you're not the only one dealing with this crap all day and night. Difference is, not all of us are using substances to numb our senses.
Sure. Or maybe you're just using different ones.
Different ones?
Yeah.
Like,
media. Or entertainment.
Or helping others to distract yourself from your own problems.
Or what?
Nothing. Stay safe, Alex.
Have a good day.
Eli.
Hey, dude, what's up?
Oh, well, welcome to my humble abode, thing one and thing two.
How was the talk?
Rosa? Oh, perfect. Just absolutely fantastic.
You had a talk with Rosa?
You know, with you, I can't tell if that's sarcastic or not.
Trust me, it is.
Well, you're in a mood.
I want to know what happened with Rosa.
Why, Ethan? It's none of your business.
Oh, it is. Isn't it, Mr. Cheater?
Cheater? What the hell is that about?
Uncalled for.
First of all, Eli, how dare you act this way? And second of all, why is Alex over there just rolling around?
Because he is. I don't know. Maybe he was drooling. Maybe he just has a bag of weed on him at all times. I don't know how people get access to these things, or even how one of those jewels even works. I'm done with it, and I'm not going to deal with it any longer.
Eli, shut up. This isn't a reality show. This is real life. Help him.
Hey, buddy, what's up?
My buddy, my pal, you came back. Oh, okay. How I missed you.
That's cool. You need to tell me what's wrong.
Nothing's wrong. It's all good down here in Alexville.
Okay, enough with the chitter-chatter. You were awkward enough with the language before you dropped a little bit of smoke and vinegar down your system. Why would you do this? It's not all right for you. It's gonna get you hurt. It's out of control.
I don't know, man. I feel bad. Real bad.
No, I mean bad. That, I'm sorry, that sucks, man. But good as in you're finally getting it off your chest. What's going on right now? Tell me about it.
I'm depressed. I'm alone. I feel so alone.
No, you're not alone, buddy. I'm right here with you. I'm right by your side.
It's been so long. I fell in love with her over a year ago. Before I even knew you. Gave her gifts and treats. She never appreciated it. Came to her door. It's awful.
That sounds like it sucks, man. I'm sorry.
It
But it goes beyond that, doesn't it?
Always does. Sounds like something you'd say. You're a good analyst, from what I've heard, psychology and all that.
Sounds like the stuff's starting to wear off. How long ago did you take it? Doesn't matter. You're right. I am. Where'd you hear that from?
Rosa. Other people I didn't know so well, but I heard.
Got a reputation, eh?
You're a kind guy. A little misshapen, sure, but kind guy. Someone worth listening to.
Somebody thinks others are good.
Thanks, Alex. I really appreciate it. But listen, you're not well. I need to help you, but I can't unless you tell me.
I think I need to go to the nurse or the doctor or something. I don't feel so good. I need to sit down.
Well, that's good because you're already sitting down, so I can help you out from there. Alex! You're awake, thank God!
Hey, buddy. What's going on?
You had a panic attack, Alex, and as it turns out, that doesn't mix well with weed and vodka. Or really with anything. Here, I'll get you your water.
Hey, I can get myself a chiller pill. It's all of you down here in Hawksville.
Yeah.
Did Rosa come?
Here? Oh, you mean... Yeah, she came, but you were still asleep. So she told me to tell you that she loves you when you wake up. She does, I swear.
She may have come to stay and check up on me for a minute or two, but say she loves me. She'd never do that, and you know it.
I'm sorry for that.
It's all right, man, it happens. Better now than later, I guess.
Hey, listen, I have some things to do at home.
You don't have to make excuses. Oh, hey, don't touch my girl, all right?
Yeah, sure. Bye.
Bye.
Within a couple of days.
That's good. I'm glad you stayed.
Yeah, me too, but I've been doing work instead of staying around.
Why are you finding something else to complain about? You saved someone's life. That's all that counts.
It wasn't a freaking heart attack. He could have been safe on his own.
You did something kind. Isn't that enough?
No, it's never enough for these kinds of people. They always ask for more from me than I can give.
Sometimes just being there for someone is more than enough. You have to let it go.
Brooke, I messed up.
You did nothing of the sort.
I did. I should have been helping him in the first place. And when I went to talk to Rosa about it, she called me out. She fought me off. And she was right. I'm always right in situations like I'm a white knight on his trusty steed. But I have no idea what I'm talking about. I'm only helping these people because I feel like I have to, and it's killing me and it's killing them. I'm not a real help. I'm just a bother. I'm just a freaking prick and a jerk who means nothing and is gonna mean nothing to any of these people in 10 years or 20 years or 30 or who knows, who cares. I'm nothing but a bother.
No, you're not, Eli.
Prove it to me. Use one piece of evidence to prove to me that I'm not what I think I am. I'm an arrogant, selfish asshole who's only helping these people, people like Alex, for my own personal convenience and benefit, knowing that I won't give them what they want or what they deserve.
That's the opposite of why you do it, Eli, and you know that.
Whether it is or isn't the reason of why I do it, it's exactly how I go about it, and that's what counts. That's what matters, an arrogant influence. No wonder Rose's parents don't like me. Or anyone else's.
Are you kidding me? What's come over you? Every time you're at Rose's house, or anyone else's, our parents fawn over you as if they love you as one of their own, as if you're one of us. As if they love you more than their own children. Have you ever thought about how that's affecting Rosa right now?
Brooke, that doesn't make any sense. Why would they do that to me? To her?
It's not about you. Or her. Or anyone in particular. It's about humanity. They just like you because you're polite. You're quick to be help and be kind, even if you're gonna be an arrogant jerk sometimes, because at least you're doing something. And sometimes we misinterpret those things and the way people are being treated. Or kids, we make emotional mistakes, and so do adults.
You're right, Brooke.
I don't want to see you hurt, Eli. You're the last of us that ever should be.
Brooke, I don't need, nor do I deserve the special treatment.
I get that. I understand that. But you're trying. You're doing something that matters.
I feel so alone. It really hurt Rosa back there. And as for Alex, there's so much of his background that I don't know, but I can already tell that he's messed up.
I'm here for you, Eli. And I know, but it's okay. You're under a lot of pressure right now.
Well, I've got a routine to write.
No, you don't. You're just gonna wing it off of an index card like you always do.
Yeah. Well, maybe that's why it sucks. I asked what I would perform for little kids.
And only little boys.
No, I perform for kids of all genders.
Then why do you talk with Rosa all the time about how you only perform in front of little boys?
Well, it's because I'm a comedian. I use sarcasm to make fun of society's stupidity. It's just what I do.
I see. So does Rosa.
Correctamundo.
I can never believe anything you two say. It's ridiculous. In fact, I can hardly believe it now that you're being so serious. It's jarring. You're so sarcastic all the time, and I can never tell if it's the truth.
To be honest with you, Brooke, it's always the truth. It's just another method of communication, and when you grow up taking everything too seriously like I did, sometimes you learn that maybe nothing needs to be taken that seriously.
You've convinced me. Now I just need to convince Alex. And Rosa.
I don't think I'm gonna be talking to her anymore.
I'm not going to sit back and watch you two never speak to each other and not say anything about it. I may be bitter, but I'm not disloyal.
I thought that the loyal thing for a friend to do was take sides.
You know better than I do that the loyal thing for a friend to do is to fight them until they both know they're wrong.
Alex. And then Rosa. But Alex will be out of the hospital in a few days. Better to speak to him and Rosa about the relationship together rather than separately.
Maybe talk to them individually first.
Individually, right.
Alright, I've got to go to bed.
Good night, Brooke. You're a great friend. I love you.
Love you too, E.
How long does it take a bus to show up at one of these things? Ah. Well, this isn't a bus stop. Nor is it close to one. As soon as I heard, 2 days, that's not a long time.
Yeah, I'm good. Nothing wrong with my heart. Left scot-free. Miss my little man.
I did. 2 days is longer from the other perspective.
Or maybe it is from both.
Are you okay, buddy? I know you just got out of the hospital, but you've been looking funny for a while now.
You've only been talking for 3 weeks. But from what I can say, it's been a hell of a ride so far.
There's a whole lot that you're not telling me.
My dad left me when I was 9. He drove like a car in the nether regions of Canada or some shit like that. At least you have parents. Stay at home and help you ease your pain. I've tried to be nice to you all this time in the hopes that you would understand, but here I am, coming out of the hospital after a few days stint for a panic attack. Yet, you still look into your eyes and see that you don't understand. You are a pretentious artist freak. Just like my father. Goodbye, Eve. I'm walking home.
Oh, Alex!
She's in the right mood for that sort of thing.
Talk?
Sure, yeah.
So?
Well, Alex got released from the hospital yesterday.
Well, that's good. How's he doing?
Great, I think. Except he had an outburst at me yesterday.
Oh no, I'm so sorry!
Yeah, it's fine. He got a little mad at me is all. He was right. I was being a bit preachy.
Preachy is a subjective term, friend.
Yeah, I'm sure, but he was a bit more right than that. I bragged. I indirectly attacked him in some way.
An attack is an attack. Can't take away that. But maybe that's more of a fault of the ego than it is about you. We always think it's about us. Doesn't mean it's true.
Thanks, but it doesn't feel that way.
You have to understand, E. Can I call you E? I'm gonna call you E. People are gonna be people. Just be peeps. They're gonna have their own problems to deal with all the time. Sometimes you gotta be a little bit selfish and put things right. You said something wrong. So what? He's not gonna be mad at you forever. Go back tomorrow, or the next day, or the next. Something along the lines of that sometime in the future. He needs a break from you. Or maybe he doesn't. Who knows? But anger and hatred aren't permanent. Neither is love. It's about making do with what you have. That's how you get things to tick. To work, like
clockwork. Well, I really appreciate that.
Anytime. I'm here for you, my trusty amigo. You're still standing there. How can I help you?
Well, I was gonna ask Brooke to the dance, but she doesn't seem like she's in the right mind for that sort of thing.
Oh, just ask her. Come on, she's not gonna kill you. It's only weed, man.
Yeah, I guess.
Never smoked a joint before?
No, I'm not much of a smoker.
Yeah, neither am I. Tried it once or twice, seemed fun at the time, but in the end I decided it's not my type of thing. On the other hand, I think it's hilarious to watch them laugh and squirm, and to be a little bit less stupid while they're up in the clouds. Hey, I know that you're in panic mode right now or whatever, but it's fine. They're still your friends right now if they look a little bit funky. Try them. Ask her, she'll even dance with you right now. What makes you so stiff, my dude? Any problem in particular?
Well, I'm a bit reliant on my best friend. Right now, she's being a bit stiff, and when she's stiff, I'm stiff. The fun sort of seeps out of it. Everything I do and who I am as a person.
Jeez, no wonder you've been so depressing recently! You gotta let that go, man! Be free for a little while! I know you! You're a funny guy and a loose one, too. I know you can dance and sing and all that wacky stuff. But you play piano, that's fine! The music is loose on the inside. And comedy, for that matter. If you can do all that without her, on a daily basis, you can sure as hell do it now!
You know what? I think you're right. I am loose. And funny and awesome!
Yeah, see? Now you're getting it. Be free again, my dude! You can't rely on your friends forever.
I almost forgot. Hey, Brooke.
Yeah, E?
You want to go to the dance with me?
Oh!
I know it's a little to ask, but friends are friends, right?
Oh, that's so sweet of you. I love you so much.
I love you too, Brooke. Have fun, guys.
Bye-bye.
What a great guy, am I right?
Yeah. What a great guy.
I love him.
Me too. Hey, Willa.
Yeah, bro.
I love you.
Love you too.
May I suggest to you, may I suggest this is the best part of your life? May I suggest this time is blessed for you? This time is blessed and shining almost blinding bright.
Good morning. My name is Eli Robinson, and unfortunately, it is the end of my time here. I'm moving on. Time constraints, passions, the vigors of high school. You'll understand one day, when you're all grown up and old like me, spending your free time pretending to do your homework when you're doing pretty much everything else. To close the show, I thought that I'd bring my piano from home. There's something that I want to show you. My favorite song in the whole wide world, about time gone by. Oh, what a night. Late December back in 63. What a very special time for me. I remember what a night. What a night. No, I didn't even know her name. But I was never gonna be the same. What a lady, what a night. Thank you all so much for having me all this time. Have a good rest of your days, everybody.
Great show.
Oh, hi. It's been a while.
It hasn't even been a week yet.
Yeah, and it's a long time without seeing each other.
Sure, why not? As performance?
Yeah, been thinking about it for a while.
I spoke to Brooke yesterday, she's still mad.
She'll get over it.
Oh, I heard you're going to the dance with her.
Yeah, are you going with Alex?
I would, but he broke up with me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
3 weeks. We're here for a good time, not a long time, right?
Couldn't help him. Guess he'll just have to find someone else who can. You know, for all that time you were together, I think I only ever saw you together once. Every time he came up to me, he was alone.
It was optimal. A good, solid relationship, of course.
Well, friends again?
Very much so. The best of friends.
A hug?
Enough is enough. Why do we care so much about these kinds of things?
Because it's all we know. From all confusion, romance, substances, every day's a hustle. Anxiety and all.
Well, we'll get over it one day, right?
Yeah, one day. Love you, Rosa.
Love you too. Ass face.